You know, it's amazing to me how nowadays everybody gets offended over every little thing. You know, you have people who are offended because of a Confederate monument, Confederate statue. You have people who are offended when you don't wear a coronavirus mask. I went into a grocery store about a month or so ago, over a month ago, and a guy came clean from across the other side of the grocery store to tell me that I needed to put a mask on, even though the store didn't require it. And I was nowhere close to this guy, but he thought it was his duty to come over and tell me to put a mask on because he was offended. And so you just have people just get offended over every little thing. People wake up in the morning ready to be agitated. They wake up in the morning, first thing they do is check their Facebook to see if somebody posted something offensive. They check their Twitter feed to see what somebody, some celebrity or somebody has tweeted. And I just think how wicked, but also how stupid it is that the first thing you want to do when you get up in the morning is drive up your blood pressure and stroke out because you are just so ready to be offended. But to tell you the truth, most people get offended more than any other aspect. They get offended at the word of God. Not only non-believers, but so-called believers and Christians as well. I know that there's this couple who used to go to this church. They were faithful in coming to church. They were there every Sunday morning, Wednesday night, whenever the doors were open, they were at church. And then one day, they just stopped coming. And so I asked the pastor, I said, hey, pastor, have you seen brother so-and-so or what happened to them? And the pastor said, oh, yeah, I went by to visit them. And I found out that that couple was not married, but rather they lived together. They were shacking up. And I had preached a message on the evils of fornication, and because I preached that message, they got offended and they stopped coming. But the pastor said he didn't even know, no one in the church knew that they weren't even married, that they were shacking together. And so, but because they got offended at God's word, they left. Had this other couple who was in my Sunday school class. They really didn't want to be in church. They were worldly Christians, but they came because they had pressure. The young lady's mother, who stayed out of state, insisted that the couple go to a good church and learn sound doctrine. And you know, many people, they'll go to church looking for a reason to leave. They'll go to church and they'll try to find an excuse not to be in church. They'll wait for someone to say or teach something that's quote unquote offensive. And then that gives them their out to not go to church or study their Bible or pray or anything of that nature. But anyway, we were teaching a series from Genesis 1 through 11, talking about the creation and the flood and the Tower of Babel. And during the course of that teaching, we talked against evolution. We talked against the billions and billions of years that dinosaurs were formed and all of that type of stuff. And so that young couple was offended. They say, oh, well, you know, these guys are Looney Tunes. Everybody knows science and science is never wrong and blah, blah, blah. But because they were worldly Christians, they were easily offended at God's word. We taught straight from God's word. We didn't make up our own opinions. And they left the church. Same, there was this other guy who used to go to church. Found out later he was an alcoholic. And one time I was teaching against the evils of alcoholism. Well, because that cut into his lifestyle and God's word was contrary to what he believed, he stopped coming to church because he enjoyed drinking alcohol. And so many people will get offended at God's word. Folks are just so easy to get offended. But this isn't a new phenomenon. This has been going on for, you know, since man has been in the world. In Luke, the 18th chapter, it tells the story of a rich young ruler who wanted to know how to enter into the kingdom of heaven. And so he was having a conversation with Jesus, and Jesus told him in Luke 8:22, Jesus said, now when Jesus heard these things, he said unto him, yet lackest thou one thing, sell all that thou hast and distribute it unto the poor, and thou shalt have treasure in heaven, come and follow me. And when he heard this, talking about the rich young ruler that was talking to Jesus, he was very sorrowful, for he was very rich. Now, this rich young ruler, he thought he had it all together, but he was offended at Jesus' words because Jesus said, hey, sell all that you have and follow me. And because God's word contradicted his lifestyle or was getting ready to change his way of living, he went away sorrowful. He went away offended because he said, I'd rather keep my riches than to follow after Jesus. His love for money was greater than his love for the Lord. And so you have situations like this. Also in John, the sixth chapter, in the 60th verse, Jesus was teaching, and there were many disciples who followed Jesus. But then when Jesus started preaching hard sermons, they got offended. John, the sixth chapter, in the 60th verse, it said, "Many, therefore, of his disciples, when they had heard this, said, 'This is an hard saying. Who can hear?'" They're like, "Jesus, wait a minute. You're telling us to do things at this." And they were worldly Christians, but Jesus was giving them spiritual food, and they couldn't digest that spiritual food. And they said, "Jesus, this is hard stuff that you're telling us now. I don't think we can hear this." And Jesus, in verse 61, he said, "When Jesus knew in himself that his disciples murmured at it, he said unto them, 'Does this offend you?'" Jesus said, "Oh, now you're offended because I'm giving you God's word?" But you know what? Jesus doubled down. He kept on going. He said in verse 62 of John 6, he said, "What? And if ye shall see the Son of Man ascend up where he was before, it is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life." But see, they didn't understand that because they were in the flesh. Verse 64, "But there are some of you that believe not." For Jesus knew from the beginning who they were that believed not, and who should betray him. Verse 65, and he said, "Therefore I said unto you that no man can come to the Father, that no man can come unto me, except it were given unto him of my Father." Verse 66, "From that time many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him." They were offended. And because of that, because Jesus was challenging them on a spiritual level and they got offended, they said, "Hey, you know what? We're out of here. We're not going to go anymore." And then in verse 67 of John chapter 6, then said Jesus unto the 12, "Will ye also go away?" So Jesus turned around and challenged his inner circle of apostles. He said, "These okie dokes over here got offended because they were living in the world anyway. Now, what are you all going to do?" Of course, Jesus already knew what the answer was going to be, and he already knew their hearts, but he was challenging them. He was trying to get them to realize, "Hey, do you really love the Lord? And no matter what the Lord says, you're going to do it? Or are you just going to stop following the Lord and follow after your own way?" Let me make this very practical example, and then we'll go ahead and try to wrap this up as quickly as possible. Let's say that you started a new hobby called quilting. Okay, let's say that you're going to do quilting as a new hobby. And so you're quilting and you're doing your first quilt and you're sewing and you're putting your stuff together and you're having a good time. And then a lady comes along who has 40 years experience. She's been quilting for over 40 years. She comes up to you and you're working on your very first brand new quilt. And she says, "Hey, wait a minute, you're doing that wrong. You don't need to line it up this way. This pattern needs to be this way and this way." Okay, if you truly love the art of quilting, you're not going to be offended. You're going to thank the lady, and you're going to adhere and heed to that lady's advice because you have a love of quilting and you want to make sure that when you make that quilt is done properly. It's the same way with being a child of God. If you truly love the Lord, if you are truly a child of God and you love to seek after the things that are pleasing to God, if a man of God comes to you or a woman of God comes to you and says, "Hey, the Bible says you don't need to do X, Y, Z. The Bible says you need to do A, B, C." If that individual shares the word from God with you, you don't need to be offended. You shouldn't be offended because your love of God is greater than your pride or your ego, where you say, "Well, I don't know why they're trying to tell me what to do." Well, wait a minute. They're not trying to tell you anything. They're just sharing with you what God's word says, that you can have a closer walk with the Lord. So if you truly love the Lord, you're not going to be offended at God's word. But there are just so many people who are offended at God's word. And what they really need to be focused on is whether or not they are offending God. That's what they really need to be worried about. Matthew, the 16th chapter and the 22nd verse, Jesus was telling Peter and the rest of the disciples some spiritual stuff. And Peter, because he still was thinking worldly, Peter was still in the flesh. Verse 22 of Matthew 16, it said, "Then Peter took him," talking about Jesus, "and began to rebuke him," talking about rebuking Jesus, the Son of God himself, saying, "Be it far from thee, Lord, this shall not be unto thee," talking about Jesus' crucifixion. And verse 23, "But he turned," Jesus turned, "and said unto Peter, 'Get thee behind me, Satan, Thou art an offense unto me, for thou savorest not the things that be of God, but those that be of men. You see, everybody's worried about somebody offending them because of some tweet or some Facebook post, or because somebody's not doing what you want them to do, you get offended. But you need to be worried about if you're offending Jesus. Jesus said, you offend me because you're not seeking the things of God, you're seeking the things of man. So what is it going to be? Are you going to seek the things of God and not be offended? Or are you going to seek the things of man? This is why we need to have a closer walk with God by way of prayer, by way of fasting, by way of studying God's word, which can be found for English speaking people anyway, in the King James Bible. I'll close with this thought. Psalm 119:165, Psalm 119:165. It says, great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord to that. Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. If you love God's word, if you love the Lord, and there's something in there that says something that's contrary to what you're currently doing, you're going to adjust your lifestyle to meet that word. You're not going to be offended at God's word, but you're not going to be like the alcoholic. When we read in scripture where it says, be ye sober and be ye holy, for I am holy. When we're reading scripture dealing with being sober and staying away from being, and that sin, that drunkenness is a sin, you're not going to be offended when that word is read to you, because you love God's law. And if you love God's law, you're going to have great peace. The people who are running around here offended, they're offended at everything at the drop of the hat. They're offended at Confederate statues. They're offended if somebody doesn't have a Corona mask on, or they're offended at this, offended at that. They don't have peace. You don't have to take my word for it. You can look on TV, YouTube, internet, everything. Those people who are offended, they don't have peace. Why don't they have peace? Because they don't love God's law. They're focused on things of the world. They're savoring not the things of God, as Jesus said about Peter. They're savoring things of men. So if we want to have great peace, we need to love God's law, and nothing shall offend us. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you so much for your wonderful word this morning, Father. Father, there are so many people in this world, Father, who are seeking great peace, Father, but they will never find peace until they first find you. Father, I just pray, Lord, that you just open the hearts of your people today, Lord, for those who are believers and those who are saved, Father, that we'll read your word, Lord. And as we read your word, we're going to come across things that's going to convict us. And so, Father, we just need to accept it and get right with you and be thankful that you're even giving us the instructions to get right with you, Lord. And so we pray for the lost, because they need this word as well so that they can have peace. Lord, we just thank you for your wonderful word, all that you're doing. We just pray, Lord, you just bless this day. It is in the name of Jesus we pray. Amen.